dim why this world we live in is filled with sorrow and care. And he looked me over and up and down, then he shook his head real slow. He said, "Son, you've come to the wrong man. That's one thing I sure don't know." Well, I stayed up there on the mountain a while to see what I could see. And I looked out over this whole wide world in its awesome majesty. But then my gaze fell down to the city and the fires and the smoke below. And I shook my head and asked myself, "Now where did our garden go?" So when I came down off of the mountain and walked back to my street, I talked with all my friends and neighbors and anyone else I'd meet, and said, "I don't know how it got this way, but I know one thing for sure. If we want it to get any better, we're the only source of the cure. 'Cause if you climb to the top of that mountain and you speak to the wise man there, once you ask him why this world we live in is filled with sorrow and care, and once he looks you over and shakes his head and tells you that he just don't know, he'll say, 'That's not the important question, my friend. Ask, how does my garden grow?'" Now some of us are just too busy, and a few of us just don't care. And some are fighting battles so hard they haven't got anything to spare. But if we just put our hands together and set aside our fears, the children of our children's children might thank us in a couple of hundred years. So go to the top of that mountain, see what you can see. If you run to that wise old man up there, please say hello from me. But I won't be going with you, not in this or any year. 'Cause everything you see needs doing up there can only be done down here.